Hey friends, and welcome back to the channel. In this video, I will show you how to build a chatbot like ChatGPT that works with your own data. And this is how it will look like. I will have my document inside the docs folder. And when I run this code, the data will be ingested and stored into the vector store. After that, I can ask any question I want about my documents, and I will get the answers straight back and also the sources of the documents that have been used to formalize this answer. I also added a link to the GitHub repository in the description of the video, so feel free to check it out. I will show you first how to set up your environment and the different tools needed. Then I will show you the script to store the chunks of data into the vector store. And finally, we will see how to retrieve information and get an answer on the documents. Let's get into it. The basic tools that we need are Python, the language that we are using, Poetry, a tool used to install dependencies, and Visual Studio Code as the IDE to write code. I will share some links in the description of the video as well to get yourself started and unblocked. But first, let's start with the installation of Python 3. In order to install Python, you need to install homebrew with the following command. Then insert the path of the homebrew directory at the top of your environment variable by adding the following line in the .zshrc file. I restart my terminal as well to apply this new path. Now you can just run brew install Python to run Python 3. The next step is the installation of Poetry. To install Poetry, you will just need to run the following command. I will also highly recommend you to install Visual Studio Code, and the link will be in the description of the video. To create a project with Poetry, go to any folder in your terminal and run Poetry New and the name of the project. This will create the basic structure of the project. Here, let's call it Data Chatbot. Let's create two other files, one called injection.py to ingest the data into our vector store, and another one called main.py, which will contain the code of the chatbot. Inside injection.py, let's create a main function, and in there we will just print hello world for now. Now, if you run the project, you can see it being printed. Now, let's start our first dependencies, python.ev. That library allows us to have a .env file with all of the API keys of our app. This .env file should never be pushed to GitHub. All of these keys are private and you don't want anyone else to use them. We will use Poetry. So let's run this command, poetry add python-env, and let's precise the version 1.0.0. And now let's try to use it. Through this project, we will need a Hugging Face API token. It is free to generate and can be done by just going to the website in the settings and access token, and then you can just create a new token. Now we can add this new token to our .env file, and we can add the following code. The load.env function is necessary to load the .env file, and after that we can access any of these variables by just using os.environ.get and the name of the variable. In Visual Studio Code, you will need to select the Poetry environment to allow you to use the libraries installed in it. To create the Poetry environment, we need to run the command line poetry shell. Press Command Shift P. Now I can select the Poetry interpreter. That's a really important step to make it work. If I run the project now, I can see my API token being printed. Now that we have set up the environment, let's code the first part of the program, the ingestions of the documents. In order to do all of these, we will use a library called Langchain. Langchain is a library connecting large language models to external sources such as Notion API, LinkedIn, or just simple documents. It allows to build really powerful tools without too much complexity as it handles the complicated part. One of the main concepts it uses is chains. A chain is nothing more than a sequence of calls to components, which can also include other chains. As stated in the documentation, chains allow us to combine multiple components together to create a single coherent application. For example, we can create a chain that takes the user input, formats it with a prompt template, and then pass the formatted response to an LLM. In order to ingest our documents, there are four steps that have to happen. The first one is loading the documents using a document loader, then splitting the documents using a text splitter, creating embeddings for the chunks using a text embedding model, and finally storing the chunks into the vector store. First, let's add Langchain as a dependency in the project. We will also need a couple of other libraries. One of the libraries is unstructured, which is a library that provides open source components for ingesting and pre-processing images and text documents to create our embeddings, and then TQDM to show the progress when the documents are getting loaded. That's optional, but pretty useful. Face CPU for our vector store. And finally, Python.env that we already used in the previous part to manage our environment variables. For that, we can use poetry add with the following lines. Here, I specifically targeted the version so that we both have the same versions and that the code run the same way on my machine than on yours. Feel free to remove the add suffix and version if you are a bit experienced and wants to get the latest version of the library. So let's create an ingest.py file and create a method to load and split our document. This is step one and step two. So we can call it load and split documents. And our first components of the chain is a directly loader to load our documents. Here there are multiple parameters. The first one is path, which is simply the path of the folder of the documents to load, /docs. The second parameter is glob, which is the type of files. So for example, here we could use only PDF, but I will decide to take all of the file. And then show progress that allows us to display the progress when it loads the files. And finally, use multi-threading to enable loading document in parallel and multiple threads. This makes it way faster. The second component of the chain is the text splitter to define the rule of creation of our chunks. These rules will influence a lot the results, and we're going to get when we are querying the vector store. These chunks of text will be sent to the LLM and will help formulate an accurate response. And there are two main parameters to take into consideration here. The first one is chunk size, which is the size of the chunk that it is creating. Having bigger chunks means sending more context to the LLM. But don't forget that we have a limit of 4,000 tokens, so we can't have our chunks that are too big. The second one is chunk overlap, which is the overlap between the chunks. So having more overlap means avoiding cutting the chunks in the middle of a paragraph that has a specific context or meaning, and that's pretty useful. Here I will create a recursive character text splitter instance. The length function is simply the function used to calculate the length of the chunk. And you can just set it up to the default Python length function. Now I can use my method loader.loadAndSplit to combine the loader and the text splitter together and returns a list of chunks from that method. The third component is the embedding model to use. In this case, we will use sentence transformers /allmini-lm-l6v2. Doesn't really matter what we are using as we can change that later, but this one is just a free one and one that is pretty good, and that is from the Hugging Face embeddings library. Finally, we are creating the vector store. I will be using Fice developed by Meta as it can be saved locally and it is free to use. Here I create my chain where I use the method, add the chunks and the embeddings model used. This will load it into the vector store variable and I want to save it for further use, so I will just call vectorstore.saveLocal and pass it a name of the database. And that's it for the coding part. To test it, let's create a docs folder and add our files inside it. So now we can run our ingest.py file, and you should be able to see a new folder called FiceVectorDB that contains our vector store. You can use other transformers and vector store to improve the result, and I will detail that more into a separate video. Now that our documents are ingested, let's see how to query that vector store and ask our questions about our documents. In this video, I will build the simplest way to query the vector store. In further videos, we'll dive deeper and see how to optimize and customize that part to get even better results. If you like this type of content so far and want to learn more about the wonderful world of AI, give a thumb up, subscribe to the channel. Now, let's get back into it. Let's open our second file, main.py. So now we just need to instantiate our embedding models with the following line. Then we need to load our vector store. So here we will add vector store equals files load local and pass the same name as we were passing before in the other file. Of course, we could use a constant here to have the exact same name. And then we need an LLM. Here we could use OpenAI, but I decided to use another one from the Hugging Face hub called Falcon 7b instruct, is 100% free and that everyone then will be able to use it. You can, of course, change that to OpenAI. We set the temperature to zero as we don't want the LLM to be creative, and also set the max new token to 100. That's the number of tokens we want to generate from the response. If you want a longer response, you can increase that number. But keep in mind again that there is this 4,000 token limit. Then we create a retrieval QA chain object, which is a chain that will allow us to combine all of the previous elements that we have together. Here I specify the LLM and the chain type to stuff. The stuff documents chain stuff, as in to stuff or to fill, is the most straightforward of the document chains. It takes a list of documents, insert them all into the prompt, and passes that prompt to the LLM. Then I pass the retriever, which is our vector store, and I use the method .asRetriever, which is using similarity search in our vector store. Finally, we wanted to return the source documents, so we can set that variable to true. Now we can call doing QA and passing the query, passing the string of our query. It will return an object with two attributes, result, which is the result from the LLM, and source documents, which is the list of all our chunks that has been used to compose the answer. Here I add some more logic to make it look like a chatbot. You can find the code on GitHub. The next thing we have to do now is to test it. So I took the Wikipedia page of Twitter that I exported it as a PDF. And now I can run the ingest.py script to add it to our vector store. I can run chatbot.py and ask the questions, what is the new name of Twitter? And see, I can see the answer. I can also see all of the chunks that has been used to constitute the answer. This is something that can be implementing for a lot of businesses. In the next video, I will show you how to export this chat into a browser and build it as a website. If you have any questions, remark, or topic you want me to dive deeper in, feel free to leave a comment below. Thanks for watching and see you in the next video.